My name is Bru Amerlynck. I'm from Bayside in North Dublin. I'm a Garda based in Sundrive Road in South Dublin. I started off in the North Central Division. I was in the Bridewell for a number of years. Started out on the regular. I progressed on to various units. I was in community policing for a year. I spent a year on an investigation unit called Operation Quest in 2008, which was investigating organised prostitution around the Dublin region and eventually around the entire country. I then moved into another plainclothes unit in the Bridewell, which is the crime prevention unit. I suppose I deep down, I always wanted to be a guard from a very young age. I went to UCD for a year, almost a year. I was probably more my parents wanted me to go to college and get a college degree, but I jumped at the guards the first time it came around. Unfortunately, I didn't pass the interview the first time, and it was the second time around that I eventually got in 2003. I've been fortunate to be involved in various units, not all necessarily investigative, such as the community policing unit I was involved in for 2 years in the Bridewell, which is in the north inner city in Dublin. Part of my duties there would have been to go into the primary and secondary schools, speak to children about the role of the guards, and we had occasion to bring in the Garda Band, for example, bring into the school children to show them what we're about. The Garda Band is drawn from a variety of members from across the board, some of who joined directly into it. It could be in the station, or it could be out on the beat, on the bicycle, in the car. If there's a concert on, or if there's a match on, it could be stationed to go there. If there's prisoners in the station, I could be minding them. If I've got an investigation to do, I'll take that on board, checking CCTV. I may need to make an arrest, questioning, all those type of activities. While I was attached to the crime prevention unit in the Bridewell, we would have dealt with a number of very serious incidents. We were working hand in hand with the detective unit there, and our investigations ranged from everything from robberies, burglaries, up to and including murder. There's a lot of other groups within An Garda Síochána who help us on a day-to-day basis with our investigations. When we have a suspect for a crime, we'll bring them in, photograph them, fingerprint them, take their DNA if relevant. They may be used for future investigations as well. If we don't have a suspect identified either through CCTV or witnesses or inquiries, we also have the availability to bring in what's known as an Evo Fit, where we'll get a witness to come in, speak to a specialist who will basically draw up a photo and of the suspect and give us an indication of somewhere to go from, which we may further down the line release to the media to hopefully assist us in our inquiries. So one of our primary duties as a guard is to seek out and preserve all evidence at any crime scene that may be of evidential value in a future court case. For example, working in the crime prevention unit in the Bridewell, we would have had numerous investigations and crimes. If, for example, a knife is recovered at a scene, our job would be to preserve that knife, to bring it to experts up in Garda headquarters for analysis, DNA analysis, fingerprint analysis, etc. And any evidence that's obtained may be used then in subsequent court cases. So definitely think An Garda Síochána is an inclusive organisation. From my own personal perspective, I'm an openly gay guard. I told my classmates of this back in 2003 and was fully accepted, and I've never experienced any direct negativity within the job. I was part of a group who set up of peer support, if you like, for gay, lesbian and bisexual members, which still exists to this day. It's good to be recognised and to have the recognition from management as well. What gives me the most satisfaction in the job is, I suppose, first and foremost, we're bringing criminals to justice. Investigating crimes, leading investigations, and when you receive the thanks, the genuine thanks and appreciation from the victims of crime, families and friends, it's something that gives me, I suppose, immense personal satisfaction.